much.
Thank you, Aja Janina. Thank you.
So please continue.
Yes, at the top, say the thing we need now, disciplined security. If they're being disciplined, they know they take bribe, they know they harass innocent people, everything will be okay. I was talking also about Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu, that I've seen the security network he has put together. I think they look more serious. They look as serious and as formidable as the Nigerian military or anybody. You will see they're ready for action, you know. So we need people like that. You know, they just talk grammar, in the back up in grammar with action. So we need people who they call otoknadu. So make them talk, make them do and.
You remember, what? Say, our federal government don't declare the group way Nnamdi-Kanu, the Linda iPod as terrorist organization. So
also, the bandits, where they disturb Nigeria, the federal government don't call them terrorists before. You don't hear anywhere where they call them terrorists before.
We have to wait to see me then declare them terrorists.
How many years?
Yes.
How many years? I'm not saying you can be BBC with the talk, so you know if it get involved. No, don't worry, I won't put you under pressure.
Thank you very much. Okay, so I want to hear your final thoughts. You know, when we talk of problem, every problem got a solution. Even though you don't talk plenty things on top of this matter, say this now, what do we do to get out of this problem, and this now how we come out this all while away the country day now. What team I want you to wrap it up. Like if you say you get chance, I know say you they always talk to President Muhammadu Buhari, you get chance talk to him, and if you get chance talk to the leadership of the Yorubas, say the government, Afeniferi, and some other groups where they say that they represent the Yoruba people of the southwest region for Nigeria, and of course, say you get chance to talk to the Yeti Hala, where we say now them be the leaders of these Fulani herdsmen, and of course, you get chance to talk to to President Muhammadu Buhari himself. What thing would be your take? I know you don't talk about your take, but let's make wrap it up. What thing would be? What thing would be all these set of people?
Let me thank you for this very beautiful interview. You don't ask correct questions, and I give you kudos, Aja Jelilat. Fantastic, one of my best interviews. If I get a chance to talk to Mama Buhari today, the thing where I go beggar, I don't talk her. Say 2 years, no day enough for you again to do much. But 2 years, please change this habit and attitude of overprotecting, overpampering your own people, of making other Nigerians feel say then they less human than your own people, of promoting chaos over human beings. I go beggar. Unite Nigeria. If that not the only legacy. I know say now wishful thinking, you know, even me as I talk and now, I know say I did deceive myself. I know say that one no day possible, you know. Because even me with the 60-year-old to change certain things for my body now, it is difficult. So to not change something for somebody who done near 80, it's almost impossible. But I will still beg him for the sake of his family, for the sake of his beautiful, lovely wife and lovely children, I go beg her. Because the people where they suffer after we don't go, now our family. Make you go check Nigeria where we're those who don't rule Nigeria before, where people feel they don't rule well. How the children they live today. Me, I don't forgive. Me, I'm a Christian, I don't forgive easily. I tell you, any time where Gumsu Abacha come on here, fantastic lady. My good friend, me, I don't forgive. I'm not the owner of Nigeria. That's what my Christianity teach me, make her go. You see people attacking, abusing, and I say, man, this girl, a small girl, when the papa will wait to concern her, give her, make him leave your own life. But people know they forgive, they know they forget. And even Buhari's wife, don't beg and beg and beg and you.
You're right. Come to Nanito, one go and